my humble opinion, your Roblox build is only as good as its lighting. What I mean by that is that good lighting solidifies the quality of your build, and it can speak to you without words about what exactly your build is and how exactly you as the player should feel when looking at a build. Good lighting turns an arrangement of building parts into a living, breathing 3D space that captivates you and helps you understand what you should be thinking and feeling, whether that be the desaturated and dull colors of a haunting gothic castle, or the vibrant and glowing red of a terrifying obstacle that you must escape, or the muted pastel tinge of a soft and cutesy world to unwind in. You could have the most realistic build on Roblox and ruin it with poor lighting. And you could have the most retro blocky style of classic Roblox and boost it to a whole new level of outstanding with good lighting. I'm Holly, I am a Roblox showcase artist, and I have been building on Roblox for 7 years, and today I'm going to show you how I go about making realistic and captivating lighting for my builds. This video was requested by one of my subscribers that posted the idea in my suggestions channel in my Discord server, so thank you very much for that suggestion. And let's first take a look at what exactly Roblox has to offer with its lighting options. So here we are in just a regular old base plate, and in the Explorer panel you can see that there's a little thing in here called lighting. When you click it and open the properties, you can see there's lots of cool different options of things that we can play around with. So the first thing you see here is ambient. This is essentially the lighting that shines down from the sky, and it is something that we can change the color of. So as you can see, when I move the slider around, we can change the hue of that lighting. We can also control how bright that lighting that shines down is as well. So as you can see, it affects the lighting that shines down, but it does not affect the shadow that's cast. So we have color shift bottom and top here, and this affects the light that's facing the sun and the lighting that faces away from the sun. So I can't really show you color shift bottom because there are no textures here that are facing the opposite side of the sun. However, with color shift top, when I make all of this red, you can see that it is affecting all of the textures that are facing the sun, and it is not affecting any of the textures that are not facing the sun. So next we've got environment diffuse and specular. These can be a little bit confusing. The environmental diffuse is essentially light that's influenced by the environment. For example, see how the sky is blue? It's quite hard to see if you're not trained to look for it, but it does reflect a slight blue light onto everything around. And when I turn the environmental diffuse off, you can see that slight blue tinge has gone away. And if I change the sky color from blue to, let's say, orange, notice how the environmental diffuse has also made the lighting of the base plate slightly orange as well. And when we take it away, the base plate goes back to the gray color that we're used to. So environmental specular. Specular lighting is super reflective light. A mirror reflects lots and lots of light back to you. It's why you can see yourself perfectly in it. That is an example of specular light. In Roblox, specular lighting tends to affect things such as metal. And notice how it's reflecting that blue tinge of the sky really well. And if I turn the specular all the way down, see how it's gone back to the pure white part that I've made it before. If I change the color of this part to bright red and then turn the specular all the way up, see the difference of how much more it reflects the light of the sun and the skybox around it as well. I really love using environmental specular light in my showcases. So global shadows, that's pretty obvious. See how when I lift up the part, it casts a shadow from where the sunlight is blocked by the part. All global shadows does is turn off that shadow. We also have lighting style. This is almost like a preset. Back in the day, there used to be so many more, like legacy and retro, future and shadow map. Now we only have two, soft and realistic. Soft lighting is best used if you're not utilizing many manual lights in your game, such as using point lights like this. If you are using lots of point lights in your showcases, which I do and I recommend that you do, realistic tends to render that lighting much better. And here's an example of a build that uses soft lighting and the same build with realistic lighting. See how the realistic lighting tends to reflect light more accurately and also really helps with that visual communication. So the outdoor ambient is all lighting that affects the outdoors, so nothing that's in a building. If I set up a really quick interior for you guys, see how the outdoor ambient affects the color of everything outside. However, when I play around with the slider indoors, you can't see a difference. Prioritize lighting quality. That's going to be difficult to show you in this base plate because this base plate has pretty much nothing in it, and so the lighting quality is going to be fine whether I turn this on or not. But essentially, notice how when I put a point light in this part and move it about, it perfectly moves around with the part. If you have a really detailed build, it can be quite laggy, and the movement of the light following the part will be quite choppy. Turning on prioritized lighting quality will make it so that light moves around more smoothly while sacrificing performance. We also have the clock time. This controls the actual time in the game, so see how when I bring it all the way down to 7 o'clock, it turns nighttime. The geographic latitude controls where exactly the sun and moon are in the sky. And finally, shadow softness. If you look at the shadow here, all it does is change the blurriness of those edges. And so that is the basic fundamental of the lighting property. But there is more. There's a lot more, actually. If you right-click the lighting and then click Insert Object, there are lots of different things that you can add into the lighting. In fact, when you spawn into a Roblox base plate for the first time, you will probably find that there is quite a lot of things already in the lighting section of your explorer. So the sky is the skybox. Roblox's default sky is this very rich blue that transitions down to a light cyan and then to a white. However, if you get rid of this, it will default back to the classic Roblox skybox, which is this. We have the atmosphere. This was added relatively recently compared to the rest of the lighting properties. An atmosphere is essentially your fog. So if I increase the density of the atmosphere, you can see that this fog really comes in quite heavy and you can barely see anything. The offset controls how much light you can see between you and the background. So if I turn this down, you can see it's not very bright at all. So when the atmosphere is really dense, the glare will increase the amount of sunlight that shines through. However, it only works in conjunction with the haze. So as you see, when I raise it, that glare really shines through, and then on the other side of the horizon is where it's dark. And then you can play around with those colors as well. So the darkness we can set to a nice blue, and then look at that beautiful transition from blue to lavender to pink to red to yellow and then to white. If you want to make something really trippy, playing around with the atmosphere is actually quite fun. So bloom controls light. So let's insert a point light so that we can understand this a bit better. So light blooming is essentially the glow that you see around light. When I turn it off, you can see that glow completely goes away. Let's turn it all the way up. The size determines how far out that bloom is going to stretch. Let's turn that all the way up as well. And the threshold essentially is telling us how bright does an object need to be before it starts blooming. So if I turn it all the way down, everything is going to bloom. The part, the light under it, even the sky is slightly blooming. And if I turn it all the way down, there is no bloom at all. Bloom is quite fun to play around with. However, a common mistake that I've seen lots of builders make is adding too much bloom. Bloom looks cool in an environment. However, if the intensity is too high and the threshold is too low, light-skinned players can start glowing as well, and it does look a little bit strange. Depth of field is another lighting property that is super fun to play around with. However, it's also very easy to mess up. See how when I turn the fire intensity up, it blurs everything over in the distance. When I move closer to this part, you can see that it's starting to get blurry, and we can control how close we need to get before it gets super blurry. And this is the mistake that most players make. The focus distance is too far away, which means that it's blurry even when you're super duper far away from the part, and it could be quite uncomfortable to look at. And the final one is sun rays. This is another one that new showcase artists love to add way too much of. It increases the bloom of the sun, and when you put a part in front of it, you can see how the sun rays are affected. I've noticed that a lot of showcase artists, when they're taking pictures of their showcases, they love to add a little bit of sunlight shining through, and a little bit is good. However, a lot can be quite uncomfortable to look at. There are two more modifiers that aren't in the default faceplate, and that is blur and color correction. Blur simply adds a slight blur to the game. Old showcases on Roblox liked to add a little bit of blur into their games. I personally don't like it, and so I don't use it. Finally, my favorite lighting modifier is color correction. Color correction only gives you a couple options. However, they make a really big impact. Brightness increases the overall brightness of the build, and you can also decrease it and make it really dark. Contrast. This will gray out all of those colors in your game. Saturation. This controls how colorful your game is. So if we turn it all the way down, the game is in black and white. And if you turn it all the way up, the game is very bright and vibrant. And finally, the last thing is the tint. This is a lot like the ambient, but it affects the overall game instead of the light in the game. So this is more like a filter. And so yeah, those are all of the fundamental things that you can play around with in the lighting. There are some that I haven't included because they're a little confusing and I personally just don't use them. So how about I show you how to use these in practice? So I am in one of my showcases. This one I made just over a year ago, and it is a 3D recreation of Zeniba's house from Spirited Away. And as you can see, it's pretty dark in here, but it won't be for much longer because you and I are going to make it daytime. So if we go into the lighting section, you can see there's lots of things that I've got here. We're going to get rid of all of it. All of a sudden, the game looks very different. It's actually quite crazy how much of a difference those lighting properties can make on a showcase. So the number one thing that I recommend you do before anything else when it comes to lighting is establishing a skybox. Roblox's default skybox is nice, however it doesn't always give off the kind of vibe and feeling for your build that you want it to. And adding a skybox is the easiest thing in the world. You can make one yourself, but I've got 5 days to release this video, so I'm going to use one from the toolbox. So if we just look up skybox and look at all these different options that we have. I want something where we can really shine the sunlight down and beam on the player. This is a swamp after all. Oh, I like this one a lot. This one is a very popular skybox. I see this one in a lot of builds on Roblox. This one's very pretty. However, the sun is shining in the overcast, which means it wouldn't be very sunny in the swamp. I think this could be a really good contender. So after some experimenting, I do think I am going to commit to the sunset skybox. So the next thing I really want to do is play around with the skybox's properties. We need to figure out where exactly the sun is shining so that we can move the sun to its proper place. The easiest way to tell where the sun is shining is to look at the clouds. See how the bottom left side of these clouds are gray and the top right is white? That means the sun is somewhere over here. And I'm going to bet that the sun is probably around here somewhere. So we're going to move the sun over there. This is done by manipulating the clock time and the geographic latitude. If I play around with the geographic latitude, you can see that the sun is moving a little bit. So we get it around over here and then change the clock time. We're pretty close, and then move it along again. And I think that is about where the sun would be. Changed up the water color a bit so that it feels a bit more swampy. So back to the sky, I'm going to make the sun a little bit smaller. And now it's time to actually play around with the lighting properties. So I'm maintaining the realistic lighting style. First thing I want to change is the brightness. I really want to get the sun shining through and blaring down on us, so I'm going to turn that brightness all the way up, and the ambient controls the color of that sunshine. Let's make it slightly yellow, like so. I've actually changed the color shift bottom to be a little bit more terracotta. You can see that it shines on these dark areas of the leaves here. As for color shift top, this is the one that really affects our lighting, and so I'm going to make it a nice creamy yellow. Because that sunshine is actually very yellow, I'm going to change the ambient color again. I'm going to bring it back down to a more neutral blue, because I really want it to suggest that the world is cool, but the sunlight right now is really warm. And so instead of doing a red like this, if I move it over to a blue, it does give off that idea that the sunlight is the reason why it's so hot. I'm not going to play around with the outdoor ambient at this time. I think it looks fine as it is. And the next thing I'm going to add is a color correction. Ever so slightly going to lower the brightness. I think to here looks good. Do I want to play around with the contrast? I'm going to raise it the tiniest bit, just so that difference between sunlight and shadow. I'm going to desaturate the entire build a little bit, and that's mainly so that green of the trees doesn't feel so violent against the eyes. We can then bring back that yellow with the tint color. Yeah, I think that works okay. The next thing I'm going to play around with is atmosphere, and I'm going to play around with it over here actually, because there are certain things over here that I don't want the players to be seeing when I get rid of it. There's lots of floating trees over here, so I'm going to reduce the density so you can still kind of see those trees over there. After all, they were intended to be looked at. During the dawn and dusk is when it's extra humid, and so you will be seeing mists like this around swamps. I'm not 100% on this, however, I'm pretty sure that Roblox automatically sets up the colors so that they match your skybox. That's why it's really important to get the skybox down before everything else in your lighting. I'm playing around with the glare and the haze right now. This atmosphere is really hard to work with and get right. I don't really know if I'm feeling it. Yeah, no, I don't think that I do actually want to play around with that. You're going to play around with this stuff, and sometimes it's not going to turn out the way you want it to, and it's more than okay to just stop working on it and try something different instead. I've also noticed that the atmosphere has ballooned the size of the sun for some reason, so I'm going to have to bring it even further down, and I'll add some sun rays so that it doesn't feel like just a white circle in the sky. Just reduce the spread of that, play around with the intensity, there we go. When it's behind something, you can see it gives a tiny little bit of sun rays, but not too much. And so I think this is pretty much complete. If I wanted to upload this to Roblox, there are definitely some things that I would change. I would also play around with the interiors a bit. These all still have the super orange lights. I personally would actually get rid of all of the point lights. In my opinion, I think this looks much better. So this is the final edit of Sixth Stop from nighttime to daytime. It's not perfect, and that's simply because this showcase was built from the ground up with the intention of being seen at night. So that's why it's really important when you start your build to actually have references and understand what you want your finished product to look like. So yeah, I think that's going to be it for this one. I personally love lighting. It's so fun to experiment with all of the different options that Roblox gives you. You can get really creative with it. I've seen lots of very interesting games in Roblox from utilizing lighting. If you have any further questions questions or need additional help with lighting, I have a very active Discord server. Feel free to ping me with your questions in there. We've got a lovely community there that is super helpful and kind. Wherever you are and whatever you're doing, I hope that you're doing well. Remember to be kind to others and always try to listen and understand other perspectives, even if they aren't ones that you agree with. You bring to this world things that nobody else can, and it's amazing that you're here. I try to make Roblox related videos every Friday, and I'd love to see you next week if you enjoyed this week's video. Okay, bye.